understand you fools hurt. Jesus, well.
In Tampa, Florida. It's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. And the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints.
We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the New Orleans Saints.
Bradley Pinion.
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Tampa. On the return, Deontay Harris. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Saints offense now getting set here and leading them out in what could be his final NFL season. The game's all-time leading passer, that's Drew Brees.
When you think of accuracy, you might as well think of Drew Brees because he owns 5 of the 6 best completion percentages in a single season in NFL history, and it feels like he's done them all in 5 of the last 6 seasons. Like Tom Brady, he thinks he can go until he's at least 45, loves playing the game, takes great care of his body, and despite missing 5 games with a thumb injury last year, showed his toughness and came back and threw 27 touchdown passes against just 4 interceptions.
Sanders has it over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Receiver downfield offense.
Now those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there. This one with Kamara. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. A good pickup after the penalty, 12 yards, and it's second down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second down, Kamara. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
He's tackled at the 34.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those 3 guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Give him 6 yards in the first down.
It's a gain of
defense
6.
Had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. They'll run. This is Kamara. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 10 yards, good for his Saints, 1st down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Midfield, here's Breeze.
And he'll get this one underneath to Kamara.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got by. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
38-yard line, second and nine. Breeze on the draw, gives to Kamara. And he'll take this one down to the 36. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of two.
A 2 yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. From the right hash, this from 53, and he missed it. It's no good, and this will remain a scoreless game.
The score remains tied, 0-0.
Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. Good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
And Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 43. And he'll throw right away. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one goes for 24 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now Brady, quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. But the Brady-Gronk connection, certainly something to watch here with the Bucs in 2020. Of Tom Brady's 541 touchdown passes coming into 2020, Gronk's 78 were the most of any receiver. Here's the first carry for LeSean McCoy. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves him at third and one.
Brings up third.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Four down.
And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Brady finding Godwin there for a Buccaneer first.
At the 19-yard line. The end of the first quarter.
No score after one on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Into the red zone, it's Brady. He'll find Miller, that's complete. And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of four. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Shotgun, it's McCoy, and he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Brady gonna try and throw on third down. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
a little closer. Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Here's Kamara off the draw. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Alvin Kamara hit the NFL with a bang, had double-digit touchdowns in his first two seasons. Now, production fell off a little bit last year. Just 6 times did he find the end zone. But his ability to run it and catch it out of the backfield makes it hard to cover. Look for a bounce back season in 2020.
Ready? So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
When you're lateral to the line of scrimmage, linebackers keep those shoulders square so they can go up and down. But when it's time to go, turn your shoulders just like a running back. Get through the line and hit the runner in the backfield.
With an extra defender now in the secondary here on 3rd down. From the gun, it's Breeze. Looking long for Thomas. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, they've moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to again amount to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. Very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
How about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. Brady now on first down. It's caught by Mike Evans. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Brings up second and three at the Saints' 35-yard line.
2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll check in with our Jonathan Coachman. He'll have highlights and analysis of the first half, and our highlights will likely be on the defensive side of the football here. Scoreless game, 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
And Brady's throw there, incomplete. The Pro Bowler Chris Godwin, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Throwing again, Brady. Throw left side, complete. It's McCoy. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a 3rd down.
Now Brady again. Open man is Godwin. It's complete. And he will have the 1st down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry, ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
So 1st and goal from the 9-yard line. Again, it's Brady. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Another shot from the 9 on 2nd and goal. Again, they'll throw with Brady. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
And now 3rd and goal following incompletions on 1st and 2nd down. ready to throw again. This is caught. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab as his guys are on the board first here tonight. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. Matt Gay on for the extra point. Gives the Bucs a 7-0 lead. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Harris on the return. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own.
Alvin Kamara and the Saints set to start their next drive. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of...
And that's caught inside the 35. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Shotgun now for Breeze. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 23 yards, the final tally. First down now, but that clock rolling. Breeze now. And he's got it. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. From the two now, second and goal. Now Breeze again. That's caught. It's Sanders for the Saints touchdown.
Number 17, Emmanuel
Sanders. Emmanuel Sanders in the final seconds of the first half. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. So a late touchdown here just before the half, and that obviously changes the dynamic of this game.
Yeah, in a couple of ways, partner, because they've been shut out up until this point. So now at least they go into the locker room, and Uncle Mo may be creeping over to their side to talk to them a little bit. And second, they're right back in the football game, an extra point away from tying things up.
Lutz good on the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime.
Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot down. Nope. Guaranteed the head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game. We'll just start all over.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
At the 23-yard line.
Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We thought this one would be a close battle coming in, and we have not been disappointed. But they are all even to this point. So to see if either side can pull away, we'll get you right back out to Brandon and Charles for the start of the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. Ogunbowale elects to not bring it out. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's McCoy. That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. From the gun, it's Brady looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick, and his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
At the 34.
First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Levante David in on the tackle.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. That's Shaq Barrett, last year's sack leader, gets in there to register another one.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
So they've been unable to capitalize on the great field position as of yet. Here's third and 9. Breeze now to throw. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
A 50-yard attempt.
The kick by Lutz is good. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead.
Saints 10, Buccaneers 7.
So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Able to knock it through, give his guys three.
I like his poise. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you see a lot of guys sag and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. Ogunbowale elects to not bring it out.
At their own 25-yard line.
Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. That catch good for only a couple.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Brady now to throw. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Just shy of the 45.
McCoy, the ball carrier.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
They'll go again to McCoy. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Given 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
2 straight 4-yard runs, and it is steadily working the ball downfield. To me, they're staying right on schedule. First down, you want 4 yards or more to set up the rest of the drive. They're getting exactly that.
Brady looking to throw on 3rd and 2. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. A rare pick six thrown by Tom Brady. He'd thrown only 14 regular season pick sixes in his career coming into this season. A couple others in the playoffs, the one to Robert Alford in Super Bowl 51. And you might remember the Titans' Logan Ryan doing it late in the wild card round loss a season ago. Lutz to try to add the PAT. It's good to make it 17-7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six.
Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this carries into the end zone. Ogunbowale elects to not bring it out.
At their own 25-yard
line. Back now comes Tampa Bay. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's McCoy. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And they'll work from the 29 on second and 6. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first.
First and 10 at the
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
Jones. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Tackle made at his 40.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Shotgun now for Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 41-yard line. 11 yards there. First down.
1 yard line.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 41. Back now in Tampa. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter. Brady now on first down. He'll find Miller. That's complete. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
4 yards. Complete to Scotty Miller. 10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
Good position to be in here, second and inches. Operating from the gun. Brady, quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
On first down, Brady. Throw left side, complete. It's McCoy. That catch good for only a couple.
Out of bounds at the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. the gun. Brady throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and it's third down. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Yards to go.
The Bucs on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 8. Operating from the gun, Brady, and he's got Miller. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay. But correct me if I'm wrong, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
First and 10 at the 11. From the shotgun, it's a give to McCoy. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Now second and 5. Snap will come from the 6. From the gun, Brady. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. And after the sack, he's still down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. Third and long after that last sack. Operating from the gun, Brady. And that is incomplete. So 2 third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with 4th down.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
Gay's kick is good. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10.
Saints 17. Buccaneers 10.
So they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3-and-out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line.
Saints take over first and 10. At their own 20.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Their lead back down to 1 score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 21. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. Defense. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they march off another 15 against your squad.
Excellent field position after the face mask penalty. First and 10 out near midfield. Trying to run down some clock with Kamara. And Kamara has it stripped, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
Well, that takeaway, partner, right there, that's a combination of coaching, execution, and absolute belief, because a lot of guys will look at the scoreboard and go, this thing's pretty well done. But they still thought to themselves, if we could make a play, we give our teammates a chance to win it. And that's exactly what they did.
So we've got a challenge. Our referee's going to take another look on the tablet. He's going to be watching to see if the knee was down prior to the ball coming out.
I love what you just said there. You nailed it, because if the ball's shifting or moving before the knee or any other part of the body hits the ground, then that'll be considered a fumble.
Tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you'll only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, and what you're saying is maybe if it takes you 1 or 2 more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now 3rd and 3.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key 3rd down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key 3rd down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 11. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
So here's Brady and the Bucs, trailing 17-10, 2:06 to play. They'll have one play, maybe two, before the 2-minute warning as they've got a 1st down.
Wait, 10, wait, 20!
So after the INT, it's Brady. It's complete. He's got Gronk. That catch good for only a couple.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You're talking about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. We've got a 1-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They face a critical 3rd down now, needing a score here in the late going. Brady's throw on 3rd down there is incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on 4th down. Brady to throw for it on 4th down. He's got Evans. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a 1st down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
2nd down and 10.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
to throw, Brady. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
Oh, no, no.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a 1st and 10. To throw is Brady. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete.
Brady's pass.
A gain of 6 there on first. Counting down toward a minute to go in this football game. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Brady. A gain of 5, good enough. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. After the sack on first down, Brady, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long. To throw, it's Brady. He's going to let it fly. And a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
10-yard line.
Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And still 2 timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, 3 kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. Little clock management 101.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They run it again with Kamara. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Drew Brees with a kneel down, and that ought to do it. So this one, a victory here for New Orleans. And it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points, that lone field goal, in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage, offense sells tickets. Defense does what?
Wins championships.
And in this game, maybe a championship wasn't won, but a game was by the defense, right? Held them to just a field goal? That's a heck of a job. I mean, when they went out there with that determination and a pretty good game plan, pretty good idea of what they wanted to accomplish, just love the execution, love the tenacity, love the way they finished.
Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we bid you good night from Tampa. We'll be right back.